So today we are going to start a new unit, that is your the last unit, 5th unit. This 5th unit includes two sections, that is the first section includes a two-port network, the second section is about your graph theory. So let us start with the first section, that is the first section of your 5th unit, that is your two-port networks. So if you observe here, the section name is two-port networks. Here we come across a new word, that is a port. Already we have seen what is a network till now. So we have observed that there is a one new word, that is your port. So what do you mean by port? What do you mean by a port? A port is nothing but a pair of terminals. Pair of terminals through which current may enter or leave, current may enter, leave the network. So this is a definition of your port. A port is nothing but pair of terminals through which current may enter or leave the network. And here we have one more definition. Pair of terminals through which network is connected with another network, which means that this pair of terminals, this port, establishes connection between a network with load, or by using the port we can connect one network with another network, that is your a port. In the port we are having n number of types, that is one port network, two port network, three port network, four port network. So let us see first what is a one port network. A one port network, so port is nothing but pair of terminals. So one port network contains two terminals. So two terminal devices such as resistor, inductor and capacitor. Two terminal devices such as resistor, inductor and capacitor forms one port network. Let us see its schematic. For example, if I take here a resistor, so this is a resistor symbol. So this is your R. If you have observed here, here you are having two terminals. So can I consider it as a port? Yes. So let us denote it with the 1 and 1 dash. So here current is entering is
For example, let us consider I, current leaving should be of I. So this is an example for your one port network. And here you may consider inductor also. Inductor. And here you may consider capacitor. So this is port 1, that is a pair of terminals, 1 dash, this is your inductor and this is your capacitor. So this here, this is a resistor, inductor and capacitor. So generally a port is indicated with, that is our network is, one port network is indicated with, or a port network is indicated with a block box. Like generally it is represented as like this. Now the two terminals are taken out. So this is a schematic for your one port network. It may be a one port network, two port network, three port network. The internal circuitry is represented with a block box and two terminals are explicitly specified. So this is your one and one dash. The current entering is taken as I, the current leaving is I. So this is a schematic for your one port network. Current, so here the port should satisfy one condition, that is of current entering from one terminal. This is a first terminal, this is your one more terminal. How many terminals are there? Two terminals. So this is nothing but a port, one port. So the condition is, for any port, it may be one port or two port or for three port, for multi port, the condition is current entering from one terminal must leave from another terminal. So this is a condition. It means that the net current becomes, it means that the net current becomes, net current, net current becomes, if you observe here, the current entering is I. So I can write I, the current leaving is I. So the leaving current should be, there should be sign difference between entering and leaving. This is your, if I consider positive for entering, I need to consider negative for leaving. I plus of minus I is equal to 0. So entering current should be equal to leaving current. Now let us go for our topic, that is your two port networks. Two port networks. So from the definition of port, already we have seen one port. One port is nothing but it contains one pair of terminals. Two port is nothing but it should contain two pair of terminals. So two port network have two separate ports. Two port networks. Two port networks contains two port network contains two pair of terminals. Two pair of terminals. Two pair of terminals. So let us see its schematic. How will be the schematic for your two port network? So this is a schematic for your two port network, it contains two pair of terminals. So this is your first pair and this is your second pair. Let us denote it with 1, 1 dash, 2, 2 dash. So internally it is two port network. Two port network. 1, 1 dash, 2, 2 dash. Two pair of terminals. That's why it is called as a two port network. Let us denote with current entering is something like I. The current leaving should be I. Let us denote with I1. And here I2. So here I1 is current is entering, the same amount of current is leaving from the port 1, and I2 current entering, I2 current is leaving. So I can consider this is your input port. So this is your input port, input port. This is your output port. Output port. So you may get one doubt that so the input port the current is entering, at the output port also current is entering. Why sir? At the output port the current should leave, but it is a standard schematic. At input port the current enters, output port also current enters. So this two port network contains two pair of terminals. So what is the generally what this two port network, how that this two port network is indicated, what this two port network contains, this block. So it contains something of, for example, so here you may have one resistor, here you may have, if I take one more resistor, if I take one more resistor, if you observe here, how many terminals are there? This is your first two terminals. Can I consider 1, 1 dash? This is 1, 1 dash and 2, 2 dash. And current entering something like I1. This is your I1. And this is, here it is I2. This should be of I2. So the total this network contains like this type of circuitry. Something like this is your R1, R3 and R2. So here you may have resistor, inductor, capacitor with dependent sources. So what this network may contain and what this network should not it contain. So here we have some conditions, like the network may contain, this network may contain, or this block box may contain only linear and passive elements. These are the conditions. Passive elements. And the second one is, this network may contain energy storage energy storing elements like inductor and capacitor with initial conditions zero, with initial conditions, with initial conditions zero. And this network may contain dependent sources but not independent sources. It means that this network should not contain any independent sources like your voltage source or current source. So it may contain dependent sources, and this network should contain only linear and passive elements, and this network should contain only, it may contain energy storage element, that is of inductor and capacitor, with initial conditions are zero. So these are all the conditions for a network should contain the two port. So if you have observed here, I1, I2, here I can specify some voltage like plus or minus V1, and here I can specify plus or minus V2. So our journey continues in the section 1 with a two port networks only. So if you observe here, we are having some variables V1, I1, V2 and I2. It means that a two port network contains four variables. Two are the input variables and two are the output variables. Input variables are your V1, I1. Output variables are V2, I2. So a two port network contains two input variables, two output variables. We have a three port network, four port network, five port network, but it is not time to, so that multi port networks are not included. Like your only the two port network is included. So the example for your multi port network, so where we can use this multi port networks is, one example is directional coupler is your first example for your multi port network, and circulators is your second example for your multi port network. And here we have a network parameters. Actually, what is the need to study about two port network? These two port networks, with the help of two port networks, we can analyze a circuitry easily. So by supplying some input and by using the network parameters, we can able to interpret what will be the response. For example, if I have applied here input, some input if I have applied here, you will get some response. The response may be analyzed very easily with the two port network concept. So here you will get response. Here you will get your response. This response is analyzed, or this response is obtained very easily with the network parameters. So what is the network parameter? The network parameters are nothing but these parameters specifies properties of network. These parameters specifies properties of network. That is nothing but in the just earlier we have seen one schematic for your two port network. Here we have denoted with some network. So these parameters, whatever the parameters we are going to see, these parameters specify properties of the network. Here we have, in network parameters we have, here we have six types. The first one is Z parameters. Z parameters, also called as impedance parameters. Impedance parameter. Second one is Y parameters. Admittance parameters. The next one is ABCD. ABCD parameters. The fourth one is hybrid parameters or H parameters. The fifth one is inverse H parameter. The last one is inverse transmission, inverse transmission inverse transmission parameters. Inverse transmission parameter. But in our portion we have only Z parameters, Y parameters, ABCD parameters and your H parameters. In our portion these two parameters are not included. So in the next class we are going to see what is a Z parameters or impedance parameters. Thank you.